Only about 1% of the population is considered ambidextrous. Most of us are either left-hand or right-hand dominant.
Liz Franz from Dunedin was a right-hander until a serious injury set her on a new path to become a lefty. Her perseverance is paying dividends at work and at play. Here's Jendy Harper.
Elizabeth Franz loves table tennis. When she tires of the robot, she takes on reporters.
It was this one. Oh, you went for your right hand, you see. I thought you'd do that with you.
Once upon a time, this reporter lived for table tennis too, but Liz's love for the game is next level.
I'm very dedicated to it. I literally think it's a beautiful sport. It's just beautiful.
So dedicated that following an accident in 2019 where she took a tumble down a bank and almost died, her main concern was her right arm, the one she held her bat in.
I remember the surgeon saying to me, so how are you feeling? And I remember saying, well, is my arm going to be okay? Because, you know, I play table tennis. And he looked straight at me and said, we have some bigger issues to handle.
Liz pulled through. Her right arm did not.
And it just doesn't move. I can do a little bit in this direction. Oh, I heard it crack. That's probably a good sign. But you can see it just doesn't do a lot.
Not ideal in a sport where a bendy wrist is a requisite. Time to give up, not an option.
And there was obviously only one solution, which was to use my other hand.
Days after leaving hospital, Liz was holding a bat in her left hand, a hand she'd hardly used.
I use chopsticks with my right hand. I use a spoon with my right hand, brush teeth, hair brush. I'm like 100% on the scale with right-handedness. Yeah.
For months, she persevered from not being able to hit a ball to having a rally, then a return to interclub. Opponents who last played her when she held the bat with her right wing, finding Liz was now a lefty.
It's far more than a mechanical shift, because the ways in which our brains are organized and functioning and controlling our movements, all that needs to change.
If Liz Franz sounds like an expert on this,
so you can see the left hemisphere, and you can see the right hemisphere.
It's because she is one.
So this is the one in you that's working overtime. It is working overtime, and this side, I suspect, is trying to become dominant.
Professor of psychology at Otago University, Liz is a neuroscientist whose specialty, brain-hand connection.
I like this one here, the woman who changed her brain, because that's you. Oh, well, with any hope. Well, this is your laboratory. This is our table tennis lab.
She's become her own pet project and incorporating the game she loves into her lines of research.
We're looking at focused attention and how, if a person trains him or herself to have focused attention, how does that facilitate playing? We all know what it's like to choke. How do we get over that?
There was no choking here. Liz took the lead and never let it go. She's played in Aussie, in Texas, and at the New Zealand Champs, she was scouted and asked to play para table tennis.
When I was approached being disabled, I was surprised. I was surprised, yeah, because I'd never thought of myself as that way.
She's embraced it now. At last year's Para Champs, Liz Franz, the lefty, won her category, a national title.
I mean, I always knew it had to be okay, because it had to be. You know, you can't but persevere. Thank you.
Thank you.